Here we can see that we have launched Machine Simulator for zSpace. And this is the basic machine. This one is called First Test Conveyor. We can see the machine description up here on the left and the name conveyor example. And this machine is going to use only two inputs and two outputs. So it shows you here a statement, and then there's an objective that tells you what's going to happen as the photocells interact with the PLC and the conveyor as you operate this machine. So when we look at this, we have two modes, demo mode and load machine. For this example, we're going to look at demo mode. And notice that it launches what we said was first test. So here's our machine. If we right click our stylus, we can rotate our machine around. We can use our front click button to maneuver the box and put the box on the conveyor however we want. If we go up to the upper left, we can view the inputs and outputs. So we can see these input and outputs. So the outputs are on the left. And we can see as the box moves back and forth on the conveyor, remember that we said we only had two outputs and we have these two inputs of photocells. If we want to advance it faster so that we can see how it reacts, we can grab a hold of it and move it back and forth and see the inputs and the outputs as they react. So now we're going to quit this machine. As we move back here to Machine Simulator zSpace, we can go to the advanced arrow on the right, and we'll notice that we get more machines. So this particular one is called Easy Transfer Line. We see the name here, and we see the name here. And we can continue to advance, and each one becomes even more complex. So there's over 16 different machines in here of all varieties, and I'll take you back now. We'll go back to Easy Line Transfer, which is our next demo, and I'm going to hit Demo. And now with this machine, you can see that as it pops up, we see our background. We have our view mode here also that we can change the background. We'll leave it in this machine setting. In order to start this machine, we have to hit the start button. Now you can see the conveyors begin to move. You can see that this also says demo mode up here at the top. Let's click our inputs and outputs so that we can see things. And if we don't want to wait on this box, let's just advance it a little bit. You can see that it advances on through because the photocell is not detecting anything particular on that box that it needs to sort it in this direction. But this box, the taller box, has a label on it that's going to trigger it to be pushed. Now if I want to see that again, I can take this box over, set it back there, and it's going to push it again, and you can watch that photocell up there work. If we don't want to wait on these two, we can move this on a little further. We have full control of everything that's on there. We want to see this box again, put it back on there. Whether that box is standing or laying down, it's going to be pushed because of whatever's on that label. Remember that we can rotate our machine left and right. Now, if I want to see the language for this, that what's actually running this machine, running the PLC, if I want to see the code, I'm going to hit Escape on my keyboard. That's going to produce this options menu. Once I click options menu, I see that I can export the variables. I can save the camera position and close. Well, if I select the path of NIRTEC and then export the variables, close the machine, and quit,